Hi guys, welcome back with me, Chao 2025, in how to train RVC models, that is a voice models. First, you could use the Mangio RVC fork here and click this train tab. Then you need to search for original voice, the voice that to create the models to learn. We want to make a Yusuke Kitagawa voices. You could actually get his voice sample from the games itself, or you could search it on the internet, especially in YouTube. I see this is an example of Yusuke voice.
Could you come with me?
Let us. A lot of his voice here, only his voices, so I don't really need to do anything more.
My persona has gained new power. What a skill! I'd like to try this skill soon. Our range of tactics is expanded.
Okay, it's like 8 minutes video. We already have the sword, so next we're going to create the experiment name. This is important. You should name it Yusuke Kitagawa or whatever you want, but remember the name, because this is going to be a name that you could, you know, later if you stop training and you want to continue, you could use this name again. Separate, I don't use any. Says where model has speech guidance, let's use it and select V2 because it's gonna be compatible. Just use whatever you have the CPU for. The more you use, the more process you take. Okay, and now enter the path of the training folder. Just copy paste the link here, and this is the first step, so it's gonna be pretty fast. You're just gonna process the data. And okay, I kind of forgot, it's gonna create an error here, I'm sure of it. Invalid literal for int. This is because the link you put here must not contain any space, so I'm going to move the voice model or the voice data to somewhere else that has no space. So yeah, there's now no space here. We could just process that again. And this time the error shouldn't be happen. And you just wait until it finishes. It's gonna take quite a while, so just be patient. Okay, and preprocess. This is and it's actually pretty fast. Okay, next you need to do feature extraction. Just do it, you know, just click it after you make sure it already and preprocess here. And RMVVE because it's better, so use this instead. Don't use the other thing here. Feature extraction, it's gonna take more time than the process data, and it's gonna take your GPU power here. But you know, I use GTX 1660 Super, and it's not really that hard, you know. Okay, don't worry if it create an error here. This is radio problem. Everything fine as long as you see the console still working. This is the error problem that I also have in Stable Diffusion. On feature none, I think that's finished, right? Yeah, I think it's all feature done. See, it's finished. Not really sure, but yeah, let's try it. Next is set frequency. It's set for epoch. This is mean epoch. It's like this thing gonna train the models, and after train the models, you're gonna train again and train again and train again. You know, every time it create epoch, then mean it create a models that you could use, and then that models can be trained again and trained again and trained again. So it's gonna save every like 5 epochs. You need this if you somehow you got the electricity dead, or you somehow you need to do something else and close the program, you have not need to start the from the start again. If you see any models, you know, you will see that most model is created like 600 epochs to 1000 epochs. So the more epochs, usually the better. But I don't know, 200, 150 also pretty good, but in this case, because you know I'm making a video, so I'm going to rate it to 20 epochs for now, and let's see how it goes. Okay, this is, you could use it if you have less than 10 minutes. You can speed up training, but it's gonna take GPU memories, so using at your own discretion. If you want to use the PC to do something else, not gonna use this. And I don't know, I never used this, and because GTX 660 Super has only 6 gigs, I don't want to waste it, because I'm usually doing anything else while I'm training. So yeah, that's that. Just train the models. And now we just need to wait. It's gonna take a while. 30 epochs with 66 super. It's gonna take some time, so we're going to skip this. Okay guys, it's almost like 40 minutes more. It's finished training 20 epochs for 7 minutes video without using the catch all training this. So let's try it out. Back to model inference. Let's refresh the voice list. And we're gonna have the Yusuke Kitagawa here. This is the 5 epochs, this is the 10 epochs, this is the 15, this is the 20 epochs. This is the PTH here. It's actually the same with the 20 epochs. It's just the largest checkpoint. So we use this, and let's try our voice now. We have a sample voice here. That is, hello guys, welcome back with me. Let's try voice. Hey, let's look. I don't even test this out, so you and me will just know it right now about the result. So yeah, it's just this. We're not going to set up many things here. Let's just convert. Okay, how the result?
Hello guys, welcome back with me, LordChaiChao2025. In Last Learning Excel, today we're going to learn about Sparkline. Sparkline is some kind of graph, but instead of...
Okay, the result's still bad. Doesn't sound like Yusuke at all, but it's not sound like my voice also. It's a different voice altogether, but... And that you get for 20 epochs. Okay, I tried to reduce the octave into -8.
Going to learn about Spark.
So it's a different voice altogether.
Last learning Excel. Today we're going to learn about
Spark. It's a little like Yusuke now.
Is some kind of graph,
but still far away for 20 epochs. You know, the best result should be like hundreds of epochs. But now that's it guys, thank you for watching, don't forget to like, share and comment, and see you again on the next episode. Have a nice day.